Yeah, all in really positive ways. The very first being, and I think I've said this a couple times, but you know, I've said that I was really scared to do it. I had a lot of expectations of myself and how I should do. And when I finally let go of that and decided, again, just to participate and not worry about competing, that was the most freeing feeling for me that I've had in a really long time. So that was a really positive aspect, obviously. And then just Reebok and a couple other things that have been thrown my way from being down there. The spirit of the games, all of that. It was a life changer.
One of my favorite things to hear is that you just trained with CrossFit, had fun, did a workout a day. Just a workout a day, right? You weren't training for it, and then that was like...
The leading into the Open and through the Open, I wasn't training for it at all. It killed me a little bit at regionals because I wasn't used to that volume. I hadn't been training that kind of volume, so like that hundreds workout killed me. But then I definitely trained between regionals and about a week before the games. So that was probably about a 5 week, 6 week training.
There's Annie Sakamoto.
Yeah. Yeah.
And she needed that
Annie
one.
Finishing. She's crushing the run too.
Annie Sakamoto, what a competitor.
So impressive this year.
Did your kids know that you were competing? And what do they think about that?
They kinda get it. Izzy doesn't really get it. He's almost three, so he doesn't really get it. Yeah, Dylan, she kinda gets it, and now they've seen it a little bit on TV. So they talk about the competition.
Yeah.
But I don't think they fully grasp it.
Yeah,
unfortunately. Or maybe fortunately.
Is your training different at this point? Like, are you kind of like thinking about the games?
Yeah, I definitely am. I am thinking about games. And the big the big thing would be strength.
Yeah.
For me, being one of the smaller athletes, one of the shorter athletes, and just looking at the weights that they use this year, strength is my main focus right now.
We did do a workout recently with Muscle Up. It was at Nate with the weighted vest.
Why'd you choose Gary as a coach?
He's brilliant.
Yeah.
He's brilliant, and I've seen him. He's come a long way since he came into the gym, but he's a total nerd. He's all about researching things online, in books. He does his homework, and he knows just how to coach me. But then besides that, and this, I didn't know this when I kind of asked him to coach me, he actually has a real spiritual side to him.
Yeah.
And like I was just saying, you know, the mental, the attitude is really a huge part of competing. And so while he gave me a lot programming wise, and so physical or, you know, fitness wise, the mental game that he helped me with is just unbeatable. He's brilliant. I think the level of competition is high enough now that it really takes somebody outside of the athlete to be thinking about what that athlete should be doing, where their weaknesses lie. And really, even though I've done CrossFit for 8 years, you know, there's things that I know I'm doing wrong, and I sometimes can't feel it. And I need a set of eyes telling me, nope, you went forward on that one, you went, you know, you missed it, you weren't totally locked out, this, that, you need to be faster. So I think it's pretty imperative at this point in the game.
Cool. Definitely have an example of enjoying the game. You can see that on your face. So
I'm doing what I love.
We're excited to see that.
Thank you.
Sakamoto, as she enters the run, she's got a smile on her face.